I'm about to uncover one simple trick that will give you a Hollywood physique. Hi, I'm Dr. Zyrowski with NewVisionExcel.com. If you're new to the channel, then as always, it's such a pleasure. But be sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification if you want to excel your health and your life, and you'll be well on your way. In this video, we are talking about the benefits of fasted exercise. You know, when you look at these different fitness gurus who stay lean and shredded all year round, and you look at these different Hollywood actors have perfect physique, and you look at the tricks that they use, one of them that all of them are using is fasted exercise. Again and again, when I look at how they do this, how do they stay so lean and ripped all year round? It's through fasted exercise. So I'm going to go ahead and teach you how to do it and some of the science behind it and why it even works. Let's go ahead and jump right into this. And at the end of this video, I'll go ahead and share with you some of my pro tips. Now, one of the things that's really important to mention here before we jump into the science is that when we look at fasting and exercise, we're talking about intermittent fasting. We're not talking about a three-day fast. We're talking about intermittent fasting where you're going to fast for 16 hours and eat your meals within an 8-hour period. If you're not familiar with this, check out my powerful videos on intermittent fasting and they'll give you all the details. Now, the reason that this works so well and that you're able to actually cut fat while doing this fasted exercise is because the sympathetic nervous system is activated. So the sympathetic nervous system, what it does simply is sets off a cascade of events that really forces your body to burn fat. Now, the sympathetic nervous system is activated because you are in a fasted state and you are putting your body into an exercise routine, which is putting a little extra stress on the body. So that sympathetic nervous system is activated and it forces the body to burn fat, as I said. Now, the next big thing that happens is there's an increase in acute oxidative stress. Now, you probably heard me talk before about chronic oxidative stress being really bad for the body because it just breaks it down and it tears down your cellular function and so much more. But acute oxidative stress can be a good thing, and here's why. Because what it'll do is it will really boost antioxidant activation. Now, one of the major antioxidants that it boosts is one called glutathione. Once again, you might have heard me talk about that one before. And glutathione is simply the most powerful antioxidant in the body. I always refer to it as the arm guard that takes the bullet when your body has a threat. Now, this arm guard is protecting you from oxidative stress, from free radicals, from chemical exposures, the list goes on. So when we boost glutathione in our body, it does some really great things for overall bodily function. Now, the other thing that is activated is a really powerful enzyme called superoxide dismutase. Now, this enzyme, what it does is it actually repairs and helps recover our cell from free radicals such as superoxide. So when we are fasting and exercising, we're getting this boost of superoxide dismutase, but also a powerful antioxidant called glutathione. Now, the next big thing that happens when we do fasted exercise is cyclic AMP and AMP kinase are activated. Now, these two cellular factors and catalysts simply force the burning of fat. They force your body to use glucose so that during the exercise, you're burning sugar, and then after the exercise, you're burning fat. And that is what helps so much to actually burn that fat off the body. Next big thing that happens is brain-derived neurotrophic factor is activated. And when we look at neurological well-being and also the biological youthfulness when it comes to your nervous system, simply brain-derived neurotrophic factor is going to help with the production of new neurons and new communications in the brain. And when we look at anti-aging, this is a really big deal. Now, just like brain-derived neurotrophic factor doing good things for your brain, the muscle regulatory factors are also activated. In that, just like what brain-derived neurotrophic factor does for the brain, this does for the muscles. It helps with the stimulation of new muscle growth. It also helps keep your muscles young. Now, we can look at these two factors in the body working as an anti-aging mechanism to help keep us youthful and also promote longevity. Now, here is a really important thing that happens when we do fasted exercise, and it has to do with your hormones. Because when we look at the studies, what we see is that when people were doing fasted exercise, they were able to boost growth hormone by up to 1,300% in women and 2,000% in men. Now, when we look at, you know, so many people who are trying to stay young and promote youthfulness in their body, like these, you know, Hollywood actors who are trying to, you know, build muscle but also age gracefully, simply what in many cases that they're doing is they're getting growth hormone. They're also getting testosterone. They're getting, you know, these different hormones because their levels are low in their body. But if we want to do this naturally, if we want to boost these anti-aging hormones naturally, simply do it with fasted exercise. So it really helps boost the growth hormone. It also does great things for boosting testosterone. And now last thing that I want to mention here when it comes to the hormones is it helps increase insulin sensitivity. Okay, when we look at major diseases today, diabetes and heart disease and so many of the other ones out there, one of the major ways that these diseases start is with the insulin not being sensitive, the insulin not being heard. So if we want to, you know, promote healing in our body and we also want to avoid these different diseases out there, we want to make sure that our hormones are staying very sensitive. And by doing fasted exercises, it increases insulin sensitivity, which is going to do many great things for shuttling sugar into the cell and keeping our bodies functioning as they should. Now, at the end of this video, I told you I would mention some pro tips, so let's go ahead and jump into those. Now, the first thing I want to mention is that when you're doing intermittent fasting, you need to be following a good quality diet. This is so important. You should not be doing this when you're eating, you know, a greasy food diet, fast food, that kind of thing. You need to be eating a good whole food diet that supports the body nutritionally and make sure that you're getting the proper nutrients so that you can actually really benefit from this. Now, the other thing that I want to mention is that if you want to really amplify and magnify the results that you get from fasted exercise, high intensity interval training is your way to go. If you're not familiar with what that is, check out the video I did. I did a very powerful video on high intensity interval training that shows you all the ins and outs that you need to know in order to start using it and the benefits from it. And so, first of all, make sure you're following a good quality diet, utilize high intensity interval training, and then, you know, a lot of these benefits, though they are, you know, really directed towards intermittent fasting and exercise, one of the things that you can do is you can actually just exercise before breakfast. Okay, let's say if you're somebody, you got some different health concerns and, you know, this whole thing just sounds a little bit too aggressive for you. One of the ways that you can still see the benefits of this, you know, it's not going to be as amplified. It's not going to be, you know, you're not going to boost growth hormone as much and you're not going to get as good of results. If you still want to see some of the benefits of this, then what you can do is simply exercise before your first meal of the day. So guys, I hope that this information was super powerful for you. Like I said, this is just the one trick that you didn't know, the one thing that you really needed to uncover in order to stay lean. I hope you implement this information. Be sure to give the video a thumbs up, share it, post any questions in the comments section below, any ideas for future videos, put those in the comments section below. And then until next time, folks, make it a great day.